out it.
Amen.
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 May God grant us the grace to be able to walk with this promise this week in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
We want to go into a session of prayer now. And before we go, I want us to listen to this video clip. It ministered to me, and I want it to minister to us. And we are going to pray about it, that God Himself will touch our lives.
Amen.
Amen. Let's listen.
Oh Lord, let's set our hearts on fire for you.
Let's meditate as we listen.
A lot of churches today now have more members but less Christians. More buildings but less relevance. More stories, less revelation. More of mechanisms, less of the supernatural. More administration but less prayer. More summons but less power. More flesh, less spirit. The world has now more churches but less impact. Lord, set our hearts on fire. We put in so much for adverts and publicity, but little or nothing for the fire. Church, don't you realize that our greatest church growth strategy is billboards and flyers, that we are not any less lost than sinners wandering in a vast world of gloom? The apostles of old had not a need for billboards and flyers. All that was expedient was the fire of the Holy Ghost burning in their hearts. That was their attraction point, not billboards, not flyers, not radio jingles, not eloquence of speech, not a degree in theology or master's in management and psychology. It was the fire of God. And the Bible records that 3,000 souls were converted to Christ on that very spot. Church, we are losing the fire. We are substituting the fire with packaging and branding. Can I remind you, the first logo of the church was the fire of the Holy Ghost. We can afford to engage it with branding now. No, let's not replace it for anything else. The billboards are needful, but without the fire, it's just a lot of flex material flooded with colors and text. The flyers are necessary, but if they're not an extension of the fire burning on the altar of the church, then it's just another piece of colorful paper worthy of the trash can. You can attract men with publicity materials, but you can't keep them with those. It's the fire that keeps men, and more so, I believe, in this terrestrial bowl long enough to understand that nothing is more attractive and compelling than burning flames. And John Wesley would say, I have realized that men love to see fire burn, so I set myself on fire and watch the world come to see me burn. Isn't it a shame that men will walk into the church drunkards and would walk out the door drunkards? Isn't it a shame that people will walk into the church fornicators and walk out the door fornicators? Isn't it a shame that people will stroll into the church sinners and would leave sinners? It's even more shameful that Christians would stay in church comfortably practicing all manner of ungodliness and wickedness. The church is full of Christians who are backbiters, backstabbers, haters, covetous, carnal, proud, boasters, martyrs, and what have you. They come to church day in, day out, week after week, year after year, practicing all wicked devices, and there's not a transformation, not a smiting of the Spirit, not an urge for repentance, because there is no fire to convict them of sin, burn away every strand of ungodliness, and compel them to the altar of salvation. Witches and occultists now come into our churches. Sit comfortably and mingle with us. Join us to sing hallelujah. Lift up their hands in deceitful worship. And even raise their strange voices in prayer. And are not exposed, arrested, and set free by the power of the Holy Ghost. Because there is no fire. We make a mockery and ridicule of the God we claim to worship. I thought we say our God is a consuming fire. Or has He stopped burning? Help us, O Lord. Some of us Christians, we are like, Lord, you can dwell in me, but let not your holy fire burn in me. I love my life just the way it is. Do not alter my routine. Do not change my ways. Don't set me free from sinful tendencies. Don't go near my addictions. Don't even try to influence my dispositions and decisions. Lord, you can stay, but be quiet. Oh, no, 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 Lord, you deserve more. God, bring us to our knees that we may see how wrecked and wretched we are without your indwelling. Church, enough of the religion, enough of the jamboree. We need real fire. There are souls to be won, extents to be reached. There's so much to be done. We just can't afford to do business as usual. We can continue in coldness and lukewarmness anymore. We are in a crucial time in history where prophecies are fulfilling and God is counting on us. We need the fire. The dynamics of fire attracts. Men can't be attracted to the gospel without the fire. The flame of fire needs light. Men will be lost without the fire of God in us to direct them. The heat of fire purifies and consumes. Let the fire of God in us purify and bring forth pure gold. Let it also consume every ungodliness and evil works. The world can't feel the heat of the fire of God if we are not carriers of that fire. We need the holy fire of God burning in our hearts. We must take heed lest we be consumed by the flames that you have born within us. O Lord, set our hearts on fire for you.
If you are in need of the fire of the Holy Ghost this morning, I want us to just rise up and pray. Let's pray. I want to believe that that video, that message in itself should compel us to cry to God this morning. Let us ask God, Lord, set my heart on fire for you. I don't want to be an ordinary Christian. Lord, I don't want to be an ordinary Christian. Lord Almighty, I need the fire. Set me ablaze. Set my heart on fire for you. It is not about the title. It's about the anointing. It's about your anointing, Lord. It's about the anointing that makes the difference. It's about your fire, Lord. Set this house on fire. I want you to pray to God. Let's open our heart to God. Let's let the yearning in our hearts. Until our heart is set on fire, we won't be able to make impact to our neighbors, in our community, in our around us, in our world. We need the fire. Let's pray to God this morning. Lord, set this house on fire. Set this house on fire. Let us burn for you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Some years ago, I just graduated from the seminary. Many of you may not know that I have a PhD in theology. Do you know that God told me, I was in the shower, and God asked, you want title or anointing? I said, Father, I need anointing. I dropped the title. In my former local church, they say, Reverend Doctor, Reverend Doctor, I dropped it. I need the anointing. I need the fire. It's not about big title. God warned me so that title will not enter my head. I did not go to seminary because of title. I went there just to have knowledge. So it's not about Reverend Doctor, Bishop, Archbishop. I'm not condemning anybody. This is what God shared with me as his son and father. You know, there are things that quench, you know, the fire in our life. We need to address them. I know that issue of big title can quench the fire in my life. God warned me, drop it. Just call me Brother K or Pastor K, I'm okay. Understand? I want us to just lift up our hands and ask a sign of lifting our heart to God. Say, Father, search me, Lord Almighty. Is there anything that is not allowing the fire to burn in me? What is it that is quenching the fire in me? Lord Almighty. Lord, help me. Father, Lord, help me. Lord, remove it, O Lord. Purge me this morning. Set my heart on fire for you. I need the power of the Holy Spirit. I need the Holy Spirit. Fill me with the Spirit of God. Baptize me afresh with the Holy Spirit and with fire. Set my heart on fire for you, Lord. Set my heart on fire for you, Lord Almighty. I need all the fire. Lord, I need the fire. Let the fire burn. Lord Almighty, set this house on fire, Lord. Set my family on fire for you, Lord. Set this house on fire, Lord. I want to burn for you. Lord, I want to burn for you. Oh, Lord Almighty, set my heart on fire for you. Lord, set my heart on fire for you, Lord. Lord, help me. Lord, help me. Lord, help me. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Did you remember what John Wesley said? Can anyone? Did you get what he said? John Wesley said, I have discovered that fire attracts people. No, he said, Lord, he wants to be on fire. I mean, let him be ablaze, set ablaze so that people will be attracted. If, for example, if this building is on fire, do you think people will not gather around here? They will gather around. Fire attracts. Fire draws souls to God. It was fire, the burning bush, that God used to attract Moses. The bush was burning, but yet it was not consumed. And Moses said, let me step aside. Come around and see this fire, this bush that is burning and it's not consumed. Our life will attract grace, people to the kingdom of God when we are set a place for Him. People will look at you and will say, something is special about you. It is the grace and the power, the anointing of God. I want us to, Lord, set my heart on fire for you this morning. I need the power of the Holy Spirit. I need the anointing. I need the Holy Ghost fire, Lord. Set faith and grace church on fire for you, Lord. We don't want to see any flesh in this church. We want sinners to enter this church, oh Lord, and not go out the same way, Lord. Lord, set this house on fire, Lord. Lord, ignite us. Ignite us. Set us ablaze. Set us ablaze, Lord Almighty. Lord, help me. Do you know that the day the church was parted, it was the Holy Spirit that was the midwife. The Holy Spirit took the delivery of the church. If the Holy Spirit is not in church, then that church is dead. Lord, I want us to pray, Lord, set faith and grace church on fire. Set us ablaze. As a people of God, set us ablaze. Lord, set this church ablaze for you. Lord, all about you. It's all about you, Lord. No more flesh. Flesh is not permitted in this house. Carnality is not permitted. Sin is not permitted, oh Lord. The flesh is not permitted. Holy Spirit, you are the minister in charge of this house. You are the minister in charge of your church, Lord. Take charge of this church, Holy Spirit. Lord Almighty. Lord, help me. Lord. Lord, set this house on fire. Thank you, our Heavenly Father.
I want to know you.
Lord, we want to know you, Lord. We want to know you more. Daddy, Lord Almighty, we want to burn for you, Lord. Faith and grace church is nothing without the fire. We can do nothing, oh Lord Almighty. Christ says, without me, you can do nothing. Oh Lord, we ask that you and you alone, more of you and less of us. Amen. More of you and less of us, Daddy. Amen. More of you and less of us, Daddy. Amen. Daddy, Lord, we dedicate our lives into your hands. We need the infilling. We need the baptism of the Holy Ghost with his fire. Thank you, our Heavenly Father. Let people enter Faith and Grace Church and be transformed. Amen. By your refining fire. Amen. Let it be so, Daddy. And let it begin, Lord Almighty. Amen. We give you the glory. We want to go into your word this hour, Lord Almighty. Anoint my tongue. Amen. Lord Almighty, set me ablaze. Amen. Lord Almighty, the word that I speak, Lord, let it be spirit and life. Amen. Daddy Lord, it's all about the Holy Spirit, Lord. The midwife of the church. The Holy Spirit, the minister in charge of the church. Holy Spirit, reveal yourself to us.
Amen.
Teach us whom you are.
Amen.
Lord, let us know you the more. Fill our hearts. Lead us, guide us. Thank you, our Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Are we ready for the word of God this morning? Amen. Once again, I want to say welcome. Before we go, and I want you to just turn to one or two people around you. Say, you are welcome. God bless you, my sister. God bless you, mama. God bless you, son. God bless you. Jaden. Yes. God bless you. Thank you. And all our brethren online, thank you for being there. You're coming to God's presence. Your life will not remain the same.
Amen.
The power of the Holy Spirit will hit you mightily. Your life will continue to experience transformation.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, our Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Please don't forget, this is our year of open heaven. Your heaven is open.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And that which God has promised us will surely be revealed in your life.
Amen.
In Deuteronomy 28 verse 12, God promised that the Lord will open to you his good treasure, the heavens, to give you the rain of your land in its season. In other words, you will not be out of season.
Amen.
In this 2020, what, you will never be out of season.
Amen.
Forever and ever, you will not be out of season.
Amen.
And to bless all the works of your hand, you will always be productive.
Amen.
You shall lend to many nations, but you shall not borrow.
Amen.
Your finance is turned around.
Amen.
Instead of borrowing, you begin to give out loan.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. It's a small thing for God. April is our month of amazing testimony.
Amen.
We have entered into our season of amazing testimony.
Amen.
Testimonies are proposed testimonies. The Bible says in the book of Revelation 21, it said, they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. And the Bible says, and they did not love their lives to death. In other words, by the time God give a miracle in your life, you cannot hide it. You won't be afraid of any devil to share your testimony.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Everybody say the Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit.
People of God want to go into a series of teaching on the Holy Spirit. And I want to beg you in the name of the Lord to get your paper, your pen. We might not be putting a lot of scriptures on the screen, you know, for now, because I want you to get used to your Bible. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I hope you don't mind. Amen. Can you raise up your Bible like my own? Can I see your Bible? Let me see your Bible. I told you last week. You know, they can snatch your phone or anything, but they can't snatch this. If you see a robber coming and you see his iPad or a tablet in your hand and or phone and see the Bible, okay, you say take. It will choose which one? It will choose the phone. And your Bible is gone. So please, we want to see everybody bring out your Bible regularly and read it. Amen.
Amen.
We'll be looking at the Holy Spirit. We want to start a series which is entitled The Holy Spirit, the Minister in Charge of the Church. Amen. The Holy Spirit, the Minister in Charge of the Church. Praise the Lord. And I want to trust the Holy Spirit to reveal himself to us. We are not just passing information. It is meant to transform our lives. This teaching, this series will transform our life. The idea is to set us ablaze. And when we are talking of fire, we are talking of the fire of the Holy Ghost. Remember when the Bible says, John said, I baptize you with water. Then the one that is coming, whom I'm not worthy to unlace his shoes, is coming to baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. Amen. When the Holy Spirit has worked, it carries fire. Why? Because God himself is a consuming fire. And he talks about the children of Israel. In Obadiah, he said, look, the house of Israel, the house of Jacob shall be fire. And the house of Joseph, flames. In other words, God wants his children to be on fire for him. Amen. Amen. When you are on fire, no fly can pass on you. Amen. Amen. That one will get burnt. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Holy Spirit, the minister in charge, and will be. I want you to know that the dispensation we are now is called the dispensation of grace and also the Holy Spirit. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You know, when you look at the Bible, when you look at how the Lord has been dealing with the human race, you will look at the Old Testament. You can see the Old Testament, the name Jesus was never mentioned there. The idea of Christ, it only, in all the pages of the Bible, in all the chapters of the Bible, you see Jesus. But in the Old Testament, you don't call it call him Jesus. So you talk about God the Father. You can see the Old Testament is more centered on God the Father. And when you look at the time of, you know, the gospel, you know, that has between the Old Testament and before the coming of the Holy Spirit, you have the dispensation of, I mean, a time or an age of the Son, the God the Son. Jesus Christ came, and when he came, that is why some people still don't believe that God has Son. It's not given unto them to understand. But thank God that our own God has Son. Amen.
Amen.
And he has given us the grace to be like his Son. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And now, from the Pentecost until the second coming of Christ, we are in the age of the Spirit and the dispensation of grace. Amen.
Amen.
So this time, we are in the dispensation of grace. And it takes the Holy Spirit for you to be able to enjoy, to be able to live in this time. Any Christian that has no Holy Spirit, he has no part in Christ. Christ says, the Bible says, whoever does not have the Spirit of God does not have the part in him. You know, if you don't have the Spirit of Christ, you are not of God. So the Holy Spirit is very important for us. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Now, learning more about the Holy Spirit will enable you to experience him in a deeper way in your life. We need to learn and relearn. Oh, if you said that, oh, I've learned a lot about the Holy Spirit, I don't need to learn anything about the Holy Spirit. No, you cannot have what you don't know. You can't have what you don't know. If you know the Holy Spirit, you experience it. Amen. You cannot be called a doctor if you don't know medical science. It is because you have studied, you learned medical science so much that you are called a doctor. Amen. You cannot enjoy what you don't know. Many of us, we don't know the depth, the importance, the blessing, the grace God has gone by giving us the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
When God talk, when we are praying, God set us on fire, set this house on fire, we don't know the depth of what we are praying. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And the Holy Spirit, now, let's look at the first part of this teaching. We want to look at the Holy Spirit and the head of the church. Who is the head of the church? Who is the head of the church? Let's be bold. Jesus Christ is the head of the church. Christ says, I will build my church. So the church belongs to Jesus Christ. We are just volunteers, we are just caretakers, we are just stewards. We are stewards. We don't own the church. No man on planet Earth owns the church, Jesus Christ. And he has only assigned individuals, assigned us to, you know, be in charge of this place, be in charge of this place. We are caretakers. Praise the Lord. So we want to quickly look at the Holy Spirit and the head of the church, that is Jesus Christ. Because if we want to know, the idea is this. If we know the depth, you know, if you know how much Jesus Christ depended on the Holy Spirit while on planet Earth, you know that, look, you can't need the Holy Spirit less. Amen. Praise the Lord. If Jesus Christ depended solely on the Holy Spirit while on planet Earth, your own cannot be different. I can't be different. Amen. I need the Holy Spirit more. I need the Holy Spirit more. So let's see how Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit, how they operated together. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Number one, let's look at the Holy Spirit, how Christ was conceived. He was conceived of the Holy Spirit. He was born of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Conceived of the Holy Spirit and born of the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Even his conception, even his birth was by the Holy Spirit. Let's look at the book of Luke chapter 1 verse 35. I want you to open your Bible now. Try and open your Bible. Luke chapter 1 verse 35. The Bible says, and the angel answered and said to her, this is the angel speaking with Mary, the Holy Spirit will come upon you. Because the Holy Spirit, Mary was asking, how? I have not known any man before. How am I going to have a son? He said, and the angel answered and said to her, what's the name of that angel? Anybody in the house? Angel Gabriel. Angel Gabriel came to Mary, and the angel Gabriel answered and said to her, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the highest will overshadow you. Therefore also, that only one who is to be born will become the Son of God. So his birth, his conception is who? By the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. Conceived of the Holy Spirit. So you can now see, when you not look at your life as a child of God, when the Bible talks about the second part must involve the Holy Spirit. The first part, which was your natural part, you know, was the one that was physical, your biological part. But the second part must be that which the Holy Spirit is involved. Amen. Praise the Lord. He was baptized in the Holy Ghost. Praise the Lord. Do you know that when we are talking about baptism of the Holy Ghost or in the Spirit, even Jesus Christ was baptized in the Holy Ghost. How many of you agree with me? I'm not passing information. I want you to begin to see it. Whatever has happened to Christ with the Holy Spirit, have you experienced it? You must make sure. You need to tick it. You are conceived. You are born of the Spirit. You tick it. Have you been baptized of the Holy Spirit? Yes, you tick it. Amen. Praise the Lord. So that we can know. Because we need to get to a point. Why am I not on fire? Why am I not enjoying the power of the Holy Spirit in my life? If that is the case. So we need to align ourselves with our master, the head of the church. Amen. Let's look at the book of Matthew chapter 3. Matthew chapter 3 verse 16. The Bible says, when he had been baptized, that is, after Christ had been baptized by John the Baptist in the water, Jesus came up immediately from the water, and behold, the heavens were opened to him, and he saw the Spirit of God descended like a dove and alighted upon it. Amen. This was exactly what happened on the day of the Pentecost. You understand? So Jesus Christ, our example, our model, actually got baptized in the Holy Ghost. After the water baptism, he was baptized in the Holy Ghost. How many of us have had our water baptism here? Amen. Praise the Lord. How many of us have been baptized in the Holy Spirit here? Amen. Praise the Lord. It's very important. It's very important. You know, in Faith and Grace Church, the Holy Spirit is the minister in charge of this house. So whatever the Spirit will not permit, we will not do. Amen. Because from the beginning, in the beginning of the church, it was in the hand of the Holy Spirit. We cannot hijack the church from the hand of the Holy Spirit. It is when you hijack the church from the Holy Spirit, you know, the Holy Spirit will not just struggle with you. You grieve him, he step aside. It is then you can now begin to do packaging, just like that video says. We are not doing any packaging. When the Holy Spirit is in charge, no need of packaging. He will manifest his power. Amen. And that is what we want to make sure our beginning and the foundation must be built and continue to grow in the Holy Spirit. Make sure you are baptized in the Holy Ghost. When he had been baptized, Jesus came up immediately from the water, and behold, the heavens were open to him. And he saw the Spirit of God descended like a dove and alighted upon him. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Number three, you will find out that the Holy Spirit led Christ. Jesus was led by the Spirit to where? To the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. Amen. One will begin to wonder, how can the Holy Spirit know that the devil is somewhere and is leading me to be tempted by him? Amen. You know, this is what happened to the first Adam. The first Adam, you know, was in the garden, and the devil came there to tempt him. You know why? What the second Adam have come to do is to undo what happened to the first Adam. That is, the first Adam fell flat into the hand of the Satan, but this second Adam will not, and he did not. And that is why we are enjoying our children of God. Praise the Lord. When the first Adam fell, man was under the rulership of Satan. But this second Adam, the last Adam, because he did not fall into the hand of the devil, we can now say, devil, you are under my feet. Glory to God. Because of this, he said, then Jesus was led up by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. Amen. Praise the Lord. Even the Holy Spirit led him. And you know the Bible says, as many that are led by the Spirit of God are the sons of God. Praise the Lord. Is the Holy Spirit leading you? If you are baptized in the Holy Spirit, is he leading you? This is very important. Are you being led by the Spirit to do what you are doing? It's very, very important. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I want you to continue to tick every point I'm giving you. What is this, the third or the fourth point now? The third point. Amen. The first one, conceived and born of the Spirit. Are you born again? If it's yes, tick it. Amen. We are doing a kind of checklist. We are making a checklist of our life, our spiritual life this day. And it's very important because we need to understand why. We need to examine our life. Why are we not on fire for God? And why is our fire going down? Maybe the Holy Spirit is, we're not getting it right with him somewhere. Amen. Are you baptized in the Holy Spirit? Yes, take it. Are you being led by the Spirit of God? You take it. You know, as you are taking it, you are your conscience you are walking to. Amen. Praise the Lord. Now, number four. The Holy Spirit And Jesus, you know, Christ was anointed by the Spirit for service. Amen. You need the anointing of God to be able to serve God. Every child of God needs the anointing. Every child of God needs the anointing. Christ was anointed by the Spirit. Acts 10:38. How Jesus Christ was anointed by the Holy Spirit and with power. Amen. How God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. And how he went around doing good, healing all those that were being oppressed by the devil. Why? Because God was with him. Amen. The Holy Spirit of God, God anointed him with the Holy Spirit and with power. Praise the Lord. So, if we are talking of anointing, Christ was anointed. Amen. Amen. Now, I want you to tick it now if you are anointed. Amen. If you have the anointing, tick it. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And let's look at the book of Luke chapter 4, verse 18 to 19. Jesus Christ got to the synagogue on a day of service, on the Sabbath day, and he was given the scripture to read and speak with the people. And he looked for the place and he read Isaiah. Amen. Amen. Are we there? Can we read it together? 1, 2, 3, go. The Spirit of the Lord is on me because he has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners and recovery of sight for the blind, to set the oppressed free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. The Spirit of the Lord is on me because he has anointed me to proclaim the good news. Amen. He was anointed with the Holy Ghost and with power. Praise God. Have you been anointed with the Holy Ghost and with power? When you talk about anointing, we're talking about the power of God. You know, Christ told the disciples, he said, don't go out. Don't go and minister on my behalf without the Holy Spirit. Don't go. He said, make sure you receive the power. He said, you shall receive the power when the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you'll be my witness in Jerusalem, in Judea, in Samaria, and to the uttermost part of the earth. It takes the Holy Spirit of God to make it happen. It takes the anointing. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's look at number 5. Even his crucifixion was through the power of the Holy Spirit. Crucified through the power of the Holy Spirit. Hebrews 9:14 says, how much more then with the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself unblemished to God, cleansed our conscience from acts that lead to death, so that we may serve the living God. Amen. How much more will the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself unblemished to God. Amen. Praise the Lord. So, without the Holy Spirit, nothing happens. Next, number 6, raised by the power of the Spirit. It was through the power of the Holy Spirit, it was the power of Jesus, of the Holy Spirit that raised Jesus Christ from the grave. Amen.
Amen.
Romans 8:11. And if the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies because of his Spirit who lives in you. You see, the Holy Spirit is the power of God. When you carry the Spirit of God, you carry power. Amen. So this power is not just ordinary. The power was so much that it was able to raise Christ from the dead. Look at how Paul puts it in Ephesians 1. Do you know that this same power is expected to be at work in us? Ephesians chapter 1. Read, open your Bible to that place. We are a Bible-believing church. In from verse 19 of chapter 1 of Ephesians says, and what is the exceeding greatness of his power towards us who believe? Exceeding greatness of his power simply means the power is infinitely so much that there's no limit to that power. Exceeding greatness of his power towards us who believe, according to the working of his mighty power, which he worked in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places. In other words, this power is at work in us. The power of the Holy Spirit is at work in us. If you are baptized in the Holy Spirit, his power, you are carrying power. You are a power carrier. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I think we are on second to the last one now. It was through the Holy Spirit that Christ commanded his disciples and the church. Amen. So, Christ did everything through the Spirit of God. When you look at Acts chapter 1 verse 12, this was his last instruction to his disciples. Acts 1 verse 12 says, until the day he was taken up to heaven, after giving instruction through the Holy Spirit to the apostles he has chosen, he gave them the instruction through the Holy Spirit. Jesus will not do anything in the flesh. Jesus never did anything in the flesh. Even until the last day he was taken up, the instruction he gave them was given through the Holy Spirit. Amen. My prayer is that the Holy Spirit, God is setting us ablaze afresh in the mighty name of Jesus. Fresh anointing, fresh grace in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
See, in the book of Acts chapter 2 verse 33, now the Christ himself now become the bestower of the Spirit. You know, when Christ was going, he said, I will ask my Father to send you the promise. The promise of the Father. The Holy Spirit is the promise of the Father. Amen. Acts chapter 2. Acts chapter 2, verse 33. Acts chapter 2, verse 33. This was from the sermon of Peter on the day of the Pentecost. If you are there, you read for me. Let me know if you have your Bible open. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Now he's exalted to the place of highest honor.
Yes, use your microphone, please.
Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now he is exalted to the place of highest honor in heaven.
Yes.
At God's right hand.
Mm-hmm.
And the Father, as he had promised, gave him the Holy Spirit to pour out upon us.
Amen.
Just as you see and hear today.
Hallelujah. So, it was Jesus Christ, when he got to the Father gave him the Holy Spirit to pour upon us. Wow. See how the Father, the Son, and the Spirit are connected. Therefore, being exalted to the right hand of God, and having received from the Father the promise of the Holy Spirit. See, the Father God won't do anything on earth without the Son. He has handed over everything to the Son. Even the release of his promise to man, he handed over to the Son. The Son was seated, having completed his assignment, seated at the right hand of the Father, passed the Holy Spirit unto the Son. Now the Holy Spirit on the day of Pentecost, the Son poured the Holy Spirit upon the church. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So in this passage, you can see the Father, the Son, and the Spirit there. Hallelujah. So you can see now that Christ is what? The one that bestowed the Holy Spirit upon us. And the Bible says, there is nothing you will ask him that you will not give. You know, there's a place in the book of Luke said, look, ask and you will receive. Knock and the door. That said, seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be open. He said, for as many that ask, they receive. As many they actually seek, they got it. And what? As many that knocked the door was open. He said, if our earthly fathers, you know, if you ask your earthly father, if you ask for bread, he will not give you stone. If you ask for fish, he will not give you serpent. You know, how much more our heavenly father, when you ask him the Holy Spirit, he will surely give. Amen. So this Holy Spirit of God is very important. It's very important. Jesus Christ depended on the Holy Spirit throughout his earthly ministry. And when he got to heaven, the Father said, my son, you have done well. Now take the Holy Spirit and pour it upon all flesh. That's the promise in Joel. Amen. The promise Father gave through prophet Joel was fulfilled on the day of Pentecost. But it was done by our Jesus Christ. So Pentecost was made possible by who? Our Lord Jesus Christ. Let's put our hands together for Jesus. Amen. You see, we are not just passing information. We have seen about 8 areas. There are many more. We have seen about key areas how Jesus Christ operates in the Holy Spirit. I want you to examine your life. I want you to look at yourself. And before I do that, I want to quickly give everyone the opportunity. If you have not given your life to Jesus, there is no way you can have the Holy Spirit. Without Christ, there's no Holy Spirit. Amen. You can see now that look, the Holy Spirit came from the hand of the Son. Amen. So if you have not known the Son, you can't have the Holy Spirit. So it is very important, if you want to give your life to Jesus, if you are online and you are watching, for you to enjoy the power of God, you need the Holy Spirit. And if you are ready to do that, I want you to just say this prayer with me. Say, dear Lord Jesus, thank you for dying on the cross for my sin. Please forgive me. Come into my life. I receive you as my Lord and my Savior. Now help me to live for you the rest of my life. In the mighty name of Jesus. As you have said that simple prayer, God answers you. He's a loving Father and he has drawn you to him. And you need to join yourself to a Bible-believing church wherever you are. Anywhere in the world, there are churches all over. And if you live in Houston, around here, why not join Faith and Grace Church and continue to serve God and continue to grow in the Lord and continue to enjoy the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And for those of us that you have gone through what we have said this morning, are you conceived? Are you born again? Or say yes. Are you baptized in the Holy Spirit? Yes. Do you have the anointing? Say yes. Now, are you walking in the light of the Spirit? I want us to rise up and begin to talk to God. And let's begin to talk to God. Say, Lord Almighty, help me. I want the infilling. I want you to fill me up. Lord Almighty, set me a place. Because when you baptize on the day of the Pentecost, there was fire, you know, the tongue of fire on the disciple of Jesus Christ. And Lord Almighty, I want the fire. I want the fire. I want the fire. I cannot do without the Spirit of God. For as many that are led by the Spirit of God are the sons and daughters of God. Father, Lord, I need the fire of the Holy Ghost. Lord Almighty, I need the Holy Ghost. Lord, set my heart on fire for you. Set my heart on fire for you. Set my heart on fire for you. The assignment you have given me, I need the power of the Holy Ghost. Lord, help me. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Our Heavenly Father, Lord Almighty, we cannot do anything without the Spirit of God. For as many that are led by the Spirit of God are the sons of God. Lord, the church is the hand of the Holy Spirit. We pray that everyone in Faith and Grace Church will be baptized with fire again. Lord Almighty, Holy Spirit of God, fill us. Lord, cause us to overflow. Out of our belly shall flow rivers of living water. Holy Spirit of God, we need you more than before. Lord Almighty, help us, O Lord. Because in this world, in this dispensation we are, Lord, for us to enjoy the grace of God, we need the Holy Spirit. Baptize us afresh, O Lord. Baptize us afresh in the Holy Ghost and with fire. Lord Almighty, this church, O Lord, we pray that as many that will enter into this church, let them feel your fire.
Amen.
Let there be healing.
Amen.
Let there be transformation. Let there be salvation.
Amen.
Thank you, our Heavenly Father. To you, Lord, be the glory.
Amen.